Hey guys, and welcome down to the Cordless Show Christmas special. Going live on Christmas Day, in fact. Now, I know what you're thinking. Shaney boy, could have made a bit more effort. Gone down a fancy dress store, bought myself a Santa Claus outfit or a reindeer's outfit. Well, I'm sorry, all right? But listen, if it's any consolation, I've managed to find you a wicked Christmas treat. That's right, standing behind me right now is a band that you knew is fundamental. But now, signed under Neo's label, Compound Entertainment, we give you the mesmerizing FDM.
Let them hate if they wanna. Let them hate if they wanna. Friends keep saying you can do better with somebody else. Saying I'm dangerous and you can do better all by yourself.
Everybody got something to say.
They don't even wanna see. While they talking so badly, I actually make you happy.
All that matters is a simple way.
I don't even give a damn. For you, I'm available. So tell them if they wanna hate, they can.
Let them talk about it.
Everybody says you're too slow for me, yeah. And the life I live, you ain't out in the club.
You wanna be the white boy.
They don't understand how beautiful that is. Hey.
Everybody got something to say.
They don't even wanna say. Why are they talking so badly? I actually make you happy.
All the madness is so sick,
babe. I don't even give a damn. When you want my beta man, so tell them if they wanna hate, they can.
Let them talk about it. Baby, we ain't going nowhere.
I think I'll sing it again.
Hey,
hey.
Let them hate if they wanna. I don't care.
No, I don't care,
baby.
Oh, baby, yeah. Woo, 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 woo.
Let them talk about it.
Yeah.
Okay guys, so you've just seen them perform. Give a warm welcome to FDM.
Hey, what's up, man? Hey. How you doing?
What's up? Yes, sir. Uh-huh. Give me five. Nice one, dude. And you too. That's it. Oh, my goodness, you're going to pull me off my chair. Do you know what I mean? So anyway, man, like, the first thing I've got to say to you guys, man, I mean, I was a big fan back in the day when you were formerly known as Fundamental. Yeah? I mean, Fundamental was like the sort of the name that sort of established you. I mean, do you not find yourself sort of still being called Fundamental now? Or I mean, is it hard to sort of rebrand and re-establish yourself as a...
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
People don't really want to let it go. I mean, FDM is just acronym for Fundamental. It's just an abbreviation.
Exactly.
So it's like, we're always going to be Fundamental. That's the core of the, you know, the whole...
Yeah, that's where it started.
You know? So if people want to call us Fundamental, people want to call us FDM. I think more people will call us FDM once the album's out. You know, but we're always going to be Fundamental. You know?
Good stuff, man. Because I mean, I was a fan. I mean, you know, I used to watch the video Jump and obviously Playground.
Yeah.
And I used
Thank
to be there, like, doing my little locks and pops and stuff. I never quite could cut the mustard like you guys. I mean,
we'll teach you if you want to.
We'll teach you. Yeah, good stuff, man. I'm trying to get the swagger emotional. You know what I mean, trying to keep it emotional, but not as good as you guys. I mean, because of these guys existing, I couldn't get a girlfriend back in the day. So
come on, man.
It's a good day for me as well as a bad day because
it wasn't that bad.
Kind of got some grudges to
you should have bought RCD for Christmas or something. Maybe you might have got some play.
There you go, man. I might have got a little bit of airplay. Do you know what I mean? I was only getting air back in the day. But anyway, so obviously back in the day when you sort of first emerged and stuff, you were very young and you just like got into the scene and it was like within a matter of time, like overnight almost, you were catapulted into the limelight. I mean, how did that make you feel? I mean, dramatic success.
I think growing up, we all had goals and aspirations and we all wanted to do this. So when it happened, it was just a case of, oh, okay, finally, like, this is what we want to do. And we basically just, when it came, it was just like, okay, cool, we need to hold on to this, basically. So I think it was just a natural feeling. And it was exciting, obviously, going on the road, touring with various artists and stuff. It was a great feeling to just feel like you're accomplishing your dreams. So it was
definitely
really good.
So the experience itself was just... was like priceless.
Definitely.
Yeah,
definitely.
But you gotta remember as well that even though it seemed like it was an overnight thing, like we had been working behind the scenes for a number of years.
Right.
Like it had started from absolute scratch. And it was like we built a reputation over a long period of time. So by the time we had got to the stage where the videos had come out, then to us it was just an extension of the work we had been doing.
What, to the viewers, it was like Rome was built in a day.
But kind of thing,
Rome never is.
Never is.
So if I could just like sort of change the tone a little bit in the sense that obviously the next stage was that you took a break. Mm. So, I mean, how did that sort of like a... Was that meant to be that like quite a long break? Didn't take a break. Okay, explain.
We were recording.
We
got our deal in America via Geffen Universal. Shout out to Ron Fair and Jimmy Iovine,
yeah, Ron Geffen.
And basically, we were just put to work, like recording the whole album. And you know, this is a very like turbulent industry at times, you know. And literally, you could just be recording, trying to get the right album. Like, and it was a delicate process because our fans already knew of us and had high expectations.
Right.
So it was just trying to find a balance, really, in terms of music and.
You see, because I hear what you're saying now, and it's good to shed some light on that, because anyone else who's trying to sort of work it out themselves would have just imagined, you know, the band's folded or they're now pursuing solo careers or just completely gone, like, dry on the idea of being
not
a band.
At all.
Because bands, generally, that's the stigma. They tend to split, don't they? Mm-hmm. So the fact you're back again is, like, just testament to the fact that some bands do stay together.
Yeah, definitely.
And the fact that you've been away proactive, recording, as opposed to just sitting down on your on your fame or whatever you had accumulated to that day. So that's good to know. But I mean, the next thing I was going to sort of shed some light on was the fact that, you, as you mentioned, supported some really good artists and stuff. So like Kanye West, Jagged Edge.
Yep.
I'm talking the Gods of Love, Jodeci. Yep. Oh my goodness. Jodeci, retracting back to what I said earlier in the interview about how you like killed my swagger. Because they exist, I couldn't get a girlfriend, you know what I mean? Jodeci, man, I played a bit of that.
Yeah, and you got it back.
Oh, mate.
I'm telling you, music is the way.
Like, last resort. So you supported all these great artists and stuff. I mean, how would you like sort of describe that experience itself?
I think I can speak for all of us when I say that that was like a great experience for us because obviously we're homegrown talent, we're from the UK, so when we started doing those shows, it wasn't just for UK artists, it was for Americans. Like, the Americans were coming over and they were like, oh, we want FDM to come and perform, or Fundamental at the time, as he was known, to come and perform. And we did shows for, like, Missy Elliott,
wow.
Bobby Valentino,
wow.
Who else?
Marion, Lamar,
112, Jagged
Edge, Sugar Babes.
We did a tour with Sugar Babes.
See, sorry to cut you guys, but this is the sort of stuff that UK-based talent can only dream of sort of supporting or even, like, you know, collaborating with, yeah? So, like, right now, anyone who's going to sort of compare you or sort of, like, compartmentalise you, they're going to probably put you in a box with someone like JLS, yeah? Because you're current and you're back again, yeah? But me personally, I'm a little bit more sort of like old school, or I like a bit more niche. So I'm looking at you and I'm thinking to myself, like, more immature, man.
Wow.
And that's a compliment, right? That's a compliment.
I think the other
day, look at those smiles, bro. They're grinning.
The other day, someone said to us online that you guys remind me of, like, New Edition and that.
New Edition?
Yeah,
that's going even deeper. But the likelihood is, though, right now, you're going to be more compared to sort of JLS, because they're sort of current and they're sort of blowing up at the moment themselves. But I mean, that sort of comparison sort of fit with you guys? Or
do you know what? Just want to touch on something. When we started out, people used to compare us to B2K. And, like, at first it was like, no, we're not nothing like them, blah, blah, blah. But you learn to just, you know, like, make your own destiny and, like, you know, make that path for you to come out.
Definitely.
So people identify you as, okay, no, that's not B2K, or that's not JLS, that's FDM. They've got their own swagger, their own style.
Yeah.
That's what they do. But shout out to the JLS guys. They're doing amazingly well right now. I think I did cop the album, and it's sounding good.
Mass consumerism.
Now, you got to support, because, you know, there's a lot of people downloading the stuff these days. But so in order for good karma to come back to you, it's good to buy the records. So, yeah, big shout out to them. We actually met the guys a few times, and, like, we're all cool with each other. So,
wow.
Yeah. There's no rivalry.
And it's a good sign. It's a good sign that boy bands are still alive. So
as
long as girls are screaming for someone, it's keeping the dream alive, you know?
I'm screaming as well, though, man. Screaming as well.
So
the next thing we've got to touch on, and this is, like, quite big news, actually. You're signed by Neo.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Is it Compound Entertainment?
Compound Entertainment, yeah.
Shed some light on that one, man. That's news.
Well, we were signed to Geffen Universal for about a year, was it?
Yeah, well, year and a half.
A year and a half. And it was kind of like out the blue. We just got a call and there was like, oh, yeah, we got a call from Neo and he wants to sign you guys. And we was like, at first we was like, oh, how's that going to work? We're signed already, blah, blah, blah. But then they worked out the deal and we were signed within, what, a few months?
Wow.
Yeah, it was a couple months. And literally after we signed...
the week, was it?
January of this year. It was like, cool, you guys are flying out 4 days to work with the man himself. And it was just like, wow, like, he's co-signing on the project, like, literally saying, like, I want to be a part of this. And to us, from where we're from, humble beginnings, and to, like, the person he is, the artist that he is, the Grammy Award winner that he is, it's like, wow, do you get what I'm saying? It's a big achievement for someone free South Londoners, you know?
Because even if I could just touch on something as well, you're actually his first UK signing.
Yeah,
yes, indeed.
First UK signing.
And he's very, 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 very hands-on with the whole thing. He's
really?
Very, very interested to know what's going on. Like, he comes in and he listens to the record.
So he's not just in some, like, some little cul-de-sac in the south of France.
No, absolutely not.
Having a cream tea, some wine and cheese.
No.
Just watching the papers roll in.
It's really weird because we'll just be having rehearsal out there in ATL or... like having a studio session and he'll just walk in and you forget that you're signed to him because obviously he's Neo, so you look and you think,
exactly.
Oh yeah, I'm signed to you. So it's like, obviously he's way up there.
Definitely.
So, you know, it's kind of weird.
He's very much a big brother as well.
Yeah.
So like the whole, you guys are signed to Neo thing is like, you know, well, that's our brother. So
he doesn't walk in like Diddy or anything like that.
But humble as well.
He's very friendly and stuff.
That's brilliant. Now, lastly, being it's the Christmas special and stuff, I'm just going to ask you a question regarding Christmas and stuff. And just wondered, are you going to be drawing any mistletoe? Which sort of celebrities would you be drawing under the mistletoe?
No, you go first.
The sweetware. Leave it to the sweetware.
I've got to think about that for a minute.
I've got mine already. I'm not going to
answer you. So you say first, because if I say it, I might
stunt what you're going to say, so go for it.
Cheryl Cole.
Okay, cool.
Holler at me.
Because he went there.
Each week she comes on the show. It's just like she comes out. The thing opens, and I'm just like, ugh.
Yeah, well,
where's my mistletoe? You know, so,
your turn. Goes.
Oh wait, does it have to be an English artist?
It does okay. have to be, yeah.
It does. Damn. Give me a second. You go. I'll just give you a second.
Oh gosh. I would say Leona Lewis. So Leona she can Lewis, just sing to me at night or something.
Nice contrast.
I don't know.
Sorry. Nice contrast.
So I was watching TV.
Yeah.
And I saw this group called The Saturdays.
Oh.
And I don't know any of their names, but there's one in there. She's got this whole Chinese kind of vibe. Don't let me see you.
Duh. Anywhere. If you're watching, get him on Twitter.
Because I will have a mistletoe hanging from somewhere and okay. lead you underneath. Look at this. Look, this is a coincidence. Me, you here. Oh, wow.
Yes. Love it.
Let's right, kiss.
Well, listen, obviously these things have to come to an end, unfortunately.
Oh,
so if you just want to just leave the fans and the new fan base with how they can keep in touch or sort of find out about what's coming up and stuff.
You FDM. Can get in touch with us on our various pages, Twitter, MySpace, and Facebook.
Yeah. But the main one is fdmofficial.com. You can just log on there. Every possible means of communication with FDM is on there. So like we said, Twitter, Facebook, all the links are there, and including our Kite Player, which gives you like daily updates of what we're doing from here, like here and there, wherever. So
we've got our own chat as well. So yeah, sometimes so you can come online, you can speak
come
to
on
us.
There, and so randomly you might be able to speak to V and Jermaine.
Okay. Well, guys, this has been FDM, and we're signing out.
Peace.